Brer Caleb, PhD. And my PhD stands for post hole digger, for I continue to work on the proper foundation for the prodigal son and daughter. And if you ask me why, because it's from heart to heart. Religion, it is said, is the opium of the people. Faith versus knowledge. See, we can have all the faith in the world, what is our knowledge? What do we base it on? Or is there fear of religion? One thing we know for sure, there is unconditional love. And what that means is no matter who you are, how you look like, what you are, but for us human beings, it looks like it. It's so important. If a doctor knocks on the door, they open. If the police is at the door, they might not open. If there is a guy that looks like he just comes off the street, people will call the police. So unconditional love, that's what we're going to talk about. That door, when you knock, will always be open. No matter how you smell, no matter how you look, no matter where you come from. That is unconditional love. And there's another little thing that I love to talk about. But let's check this out first. See, more and more people are hearing about stress. Going through this pandemic causes a lot of stress. And the word oxidative stress, some people hear this for the first time and others are familiar with it, because oxidative stress has been around since that mankind was around. Now you say, how come I don't know about that? Well, there is always a group of people that will know things, other people that wonder about things, and other people say, I didn't know. So let's go over oxidative stress just to simplify matters. It turns you to be an old prune. Stress is proven that you, when you are 20 years of age, you look fantastic. When you're 30, you start to change a little bit. When you're 40, there seems to be another change occurring. They call it the midlife crisis. When you're 50 or 60, you start to wrinkle. You are kriput, as they say in Indonesian. Or you are like an old prune. But is that necessary? You see, I am 70 years of age. I was born in 1950, June. And as of the video, this is the end of October 2020. So I am over 70 years, about 70 plus, half year old. Now, do I brag about who I am, what I am? No, but I'm trying to make a point. When my little boy passed away in my arms, when he was only 7.5 months old, I was rudely interrupted in my day-to-day lifestyle. I thought we had everything. We had a family with a nice home. We had businesses. We had the cars. We had the ability to travel. We had a music group. We just got our record. And here's my little baby boy. My wife calls me January the 30th, 10 o'clock in the morning, and she asked me to come down because something was happening. And I picked him up, and he was lifeless. Now, we can have all kinds of discussion how, what, and where. But the fact was, in my life, I had never considered it. I'd been to many funerals, but when you have your own son dead in your arms, I tell you learn lessons that you cannot learn from books. That it's something when a lifeless person, little baby boy, is in your arms that teaches you something. And I learned the respect for life versus money. Because money, all the money in the world, will not get that little boy back. But what can I do? And I started to look at how do I live? Why do I live? Why is all the stress put on? Because stress, oxidative stress, is what ages us. Oxidative is like oxygen, that is wonderful, but oxidative, that is rusting us out. It sounds funny. But that is part and parcel of the problem that we are all finding. Some people are very healthy. They are health nuts and they look like old trees. Now the Bible talks about something else. And I know that restorative justice is basically bringing us back. It is not a religion. It is just the way restorative justice has been designed. God created something so that we found a way, the way. The way, the truth, and the light. And that restores the relationship between you and me. You and God. Me and God, or God and me. That is important. That is what we're talking about. And that is awesome. Have you ever done some Grammarly or some spell checking unit? I use them on a daily basis. I go through hundreds of words. Actually, I've gone through somewhere. They told me I went through 17 million words already over the last 3 or 4 years. I write books, I write for other things, and I'm always checking, compare. If I get emails, I will double check. Quite often I fix mistakes. So to err is human. To edit is divine. So we might like to do something else for today. This is an observation, to complete and to be accurate. In other words, what I'm sharing with you, I've done to the best of my ability. Therefore, use this information only as a guide. Don't use it as the ultimate spiritual knowledge. But what I'm sharing with you is a basic challenge of Deception Protocol Simplified, the Prodigal Son Blueprint. I hope that you remember that that is why we started. I always wondered, where does Christianity really come from? Because Christianity in my life has caused a lot of problems, fights, arguments, excommunications, and all kinds of unpleasant stuff. So I discovered that there is a book written by a fellow that a lot of people have heard of. He was a historian that lived in the time of Yeshua HaMashiach. For most of you are known to familiar as Jesus. And several of the people wrote about Christianity Revealed, an Essene life. It was not an Obscene, but the Essenes. That was a tribe. It was a group of people, the early or first century believers, followers of Yeshua. And according to Josephus, the Essenes were one of the three major Jewish philosophies. So in other words, there were the Pharisees. They were mostly lay people. And then you had the Sadducees, the aristocrats, the influential priestly class of Jerusalem. And Josephus says there were 6,000 Pharisees and 4,000 Essenes in Judea. The Pharisees were less radical than the Essenes and were ready to compromise with the Sadducees and to some extent cooperate with the Romans. Well, the Essenes had a teacher, and the teacher was called the Teacher of Righteousness. Jewish scriptures confirmed it, and others are sectarian documents that unexpected came to the surface. We found them in Egypt. We found them in the desert where they were locked up in pots of clay. Some of them they have been able to find and secure, not to find, but just to secure after they found them. And we have another scenario. They found the Damascus documents in 1897 in Cairo synagogue. It tells the story of a group of Jews who, with their teacher of righteousness, went to a place in the wilderness where they seemed to call Damascus to uphold the law. Now that sounds interesting, doesn't it? Now I am retired and therefore able to reflect on life. I'm also an author in book form and a web author with no restraints on what I think or right to afford to be trustworthy. I'm peering down dangerous dark alleys, different than someone with a career without going to the trouble who I might annoy. In other words, if I would have been a job that I was dependent on an income from that particular group, then I wouldn't be able to come out with all this. But I do comment with respect for verifying evidence. In other words, I'm very cautious. I verify the evidence before I share with you what I'm talking about. I had a very strict teacher, life, and now I enjoy it in abundance. Now, some of us keep on pouring salt, though sometimes it might be wise to stop living in pain, because if you continue living in pain, you live in the past. And when the past catches up with you, it will block your future, folks. Now, I used to have a farm, and there is called common sense. So my advice as a former farmer and a person that just used common sense, stop torturing yourself for mistakes of the past. Learn to forgive and to forget, but to gain knowledge of the mistakes made. Through a poor example, I compare our lives to a missile. You shoot the darn thing, you aim for it, and in general, it will hit somewhere. Now, then they base the correction system on the errors it makes to arrive at the proper designation. That is how a missile is basically gone off. Now, some people like to be perfect. They never like to make mistakes. So gaining knowledge from your mistakes, consider yourself a mix-up that corrects his path to arrive at the proper destination. To live life to its fullest and to be more than overcomer, live the wow factor. Wow means W-O-W, learning to overcome the impossible and walk on water with Yeshua HaMashiach, also known as Jesus. He left a small path and he named it the way, the truth and the light. And if we are willing to go the extra mile where others are uncertain, we will get into that wow factor. W-O-W. You can't spell it wrong, because if you do it backwards, you still have walking on water. Wow. Now, when you take that route, my friend, it is the extra mile that you're putting in that pays off. Some like to say that the best way to predict the future, including your future, is to create it. It is how you do it and how you become creative. And as you reconnect with the creator of the universe through restorative justice, you are a child of the creator, Elohim God. And how do I know this? I walk that road called the way. Though restricted to prison, a physical prison called Millhaven Maximum Security in Ontario, Canada, and I hope that some inmates are watching this, for I disagreed with some who consider themselves kings of this world. Uh-oh. However, in name they were called Freemasons, connected to the Illuminati, who supposedly control the money. Wow, impressive. So they have so much power to block you in anything, unless you do what they say. Well, the beauty is, I'm just a passerby. And in passing, I noticed my friend John Bunyan, who walked that road as many others did. And I do not say it is easy, but for the grace of the Lord, it is possible to learn to walk on water or enter the wow factor. W-O-W, walk on water. Are we therefore new doctors that can cure society? I don't think so. We apply old remedies prepared for us, which work when used in amazement. Amazement of us ignorant people. Yes, folks, it is a lack of knowledge that is what hurting us. See, there's one thing you learn when you go through a prison term, and mine was spelled 6 years times three. That was concurrent. I got punished harder than a guy who killed three people and got 4 years or 5 years. And why? Because the system is designed by people that live in this world. When we travel without pretense and an open mind, we will realize that many issues are no longer a problem. Every person can heal themselves, for it is an untreated past which causes most diseases. Biohackers, people that like to take control over their own health, physical as well as spiritual, find the adage, "Know thyself," is more accurate now than ever before. Now, this is an aspect which I am so excited about, because once you get to know yourself, not what other people say you are, you're stupid, you can't. Once you get to know yourself, you can close the doors that hinders you for many years, and some even their whole life. We learned that oxidative stress is not only causing us to age, but it gets you also kriput, like wrinkled. Your face starts to just like an old shoe. Now, if you wonder what is oxidative stress, now, just in a synopsis, everything you should know about oxidative stress is on the web. It is an imbalance between free radicals and antioxidants in your body. It sits in your DNA. It affects it. It's free radicals or oxidant-containing molecules. I don't want to go too deep on it because it is important to understand you are in control of your life. It doesn't matter who is trying to overpower you. If you make up your mind and you get to know yourself, you will be able to recognize that tough times never last, but tough people do. And so you can walk the wow factor, walking on water. And if you don't get that message, please do something about your past by forgiving yourself and starting a new life with Yeshua HaMashiach. How do you do that? Contact me. And I love to continue talking with you. God bless you. Tough times never last, but tough people, they do.
Thank you. Thank you.